back to another video. So this video I'm going to be doing a high school tag questions. So I left school and I thought I'd do a little Q&A and a tag telling you about kind of answering questions. So I got some questions here and I'm going to answer them. So make sure to give a big thumbs up, subscribe, follow me on Instagram, Millie Evangeline, which will be in the description below. And let's get into the video. Is, year did you leave school? So I'm class of 2016. I left school in 2021. We're in England, so we don't have grades, we have years. And I left in year 11, and then college in sixth forms year 12 and 13, and I'm going to college. What is your favourite subject? My favourite subject when I was in school was music, but then we didn't end up always doing music, so I did like drama and music, but mostly people just went to mess around, so I did music and acting outside of school, which I still do now. And my full favourite lesson was probably English. I really liked writing stories and things like that. So the next thing is, what did you really struggle with in school? I really struggled with maths. I have dyslexia and dyscalculia, I think that's how you say it, is maths dyslexia. Not many people know of it. It's not noticed enough as it should be. The teachers didn't know how to teach me with it, so I definitely had trouble with that, and I had mild dyslexia, so where the words don't, well, you probably know what dyslexia is, but maths dyslexia, which is what you call it in short term, is actually called dyscalculia. It's like the when the letters move around, or you can't read, it's basically the same with numbers, like counting, and you don't really get maths. It's basically like the actual dyslexia one, so I have really bad, like severe maths dyslexia, but mild dyslexia. Group where you're in at school, like populars or like that. So when I was in year 7, I was like in the kind of weirder group, as you would say, but I was also in the popular group, so I knew the populars and I used to go around them sometimes, but I also wasn't always with them, so I was kind of in the middle of both. And I was friends with populars, kind of the popular people outside of school that I used to go around with. And then when I got into year 8, to be honest, it kind of went downhill. I stayed friends with some of them, and I kind of went around with some of them sometimes, still in year 8, but not as much. I kind of drifted more into the weird group. And that was when I was in mainstream classes. I'm in mainstream school. Went into year 9, I was still in the mainstream school, I just went into a different class which was smaller, so they could help me more with what I was finding difficult in school. And the kind of weirder group were not being as nice as they were, so I was kind of glad to go in there, and I just made friends with people in there, because there wasn't really any groups in there, so we just kind of stayed how we were, and I was still friends with some of them side of school. But I mean, I love school just kind of being friends with people in there, so I had a good time, and I'm quite glad I got to experience some of the popular side of school, but not completely. So yeah, that was good. Kind of glad I didn't stay in there, because I mean, they just weren't the nicest people. What subject do you hate the most and why? The subject I hate the most and why is maths, and science is basically maths too, because I just don't understand it, and it's really, 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 really difficult. Describe what you wear to school, your uniform. So our school, we had blazers, a tie, white t-shirts, skirt, tights and school shoes. And for PE, we had a PE top, and you could wear a skirt or shorts. So pretty much just a normal English school uniform. What subjects did you pick? So when we get to year 9, we have to pick what subjects we want to do for year 10 and 11 for our GCSEs. So obviously I had to do English, biology, chemistry, physics, if I said maths I don't remember, and then English literature and English language. I wanted to pick history, but the teacher there wasn't, he wasn't very understanding of what I found difficult, so I didn't end up picking history. So I picked geography and I picked photography and I picked iMedia. For some reason, we didn't end up doing that. And the class we were in, we had to do travel and tourism. I ended up dropping lessons because I found it difficult with school. So I got put on a reduced timetable because that's fun, difficult being in school sometimes. But then I got used to it again, so I'm not sure. So I ended up dropping geography and photography. I also did early years, which is child development. So yeah, I ended up only doing early years as my option. Early years, English literature, English language, chemistry, biology, physics, and maths. And then I do music outside of school where I do piano. I have a piano teacher, I do piano. I teach myself the trumpet, I used to have lessons. And I go on Saturdays, I go to a theatre school called the Bolingbroke Academy, and we do film, TV, musical theatre, and comedy and drama, and I love the film and TV, it's so good. So yeah, I do acting outside. Being a teacher's pet. I mean, I don't really see the thing as teacher's pet. I definitely had teachers which I spoke to and I really liked. I wasn't sure if I was like a teacher's pet fully, but I definitely spoke to some teachers, yes. Were you part of your school musical? I was part of it, but then it kind of stopped because the teachers were just not teaching it properly, so they kind of stopped the music, which is quite annoying. Did you participate in any sports at school? When I was in, I think it was year 8, I loved football. I was obsessed with football. So I've probably done every music thing you can think of. I've done dancing, I've done jazz, modern, street dance, ballet, scouts, brownies, trumpet, piano, acting, singing, dancing, guides. I've literally done so many things because I've just tried things to see. I'm trying to find what I like. A skateboard, yeah, I'm in street wear. But then when I was in year 7, I was really obsessed with football. And I used to go out to the field by my house each day. I used to run. I used to get my friends to help me train football. I used to do football all the time. And I kind of zoned out of it a bit to find some other things that I liked more than football. The head captain was really horrible to me. I used to zone out a lot sometimes. Well, not on the football pitch, but just she always thought I was zoning out, but I used to zone out when I wasn't mainly, and it was just. It just wasn't the thing that was for me in the end of the day. What is your favourite school meal? When I was in primary school, I know it's related to high school, but when I was in primary school, they did these macaroni and cheeses, and they were the best thing ever. And in high school, if you have those in England, Pasta King, I think it's called. Pasta, oh my gosh, I used to get that every single day. It was amazing, and the teacher used to get it too, and it was just so good. Have you ever ditched school? I was in primary school, definitely, because I was always so nervous to go to school that I used to a lot. Yeah, I think we all have. I have. What's the craziest thing that's happened at school? I mean, I remember I was practicing this thing, like lockdown, you go onto the tables, and then a man actually ended up. I wasn't actually at school that day, so I can't really say that I was there, but this man actually was near the school, so they had to do this lockdown thing with, like, when someone comes into school with a gun, which is rare in England, but it has happened. Craziest thing that happened in school when I was there. I remember I got. So, probably something. We had this IT teacher, and he wasn't really teaching. I was probably. Because he was a supply, because our other teacher wasn't there. And my water fell out all over my bag. And me and this girl said, "Oh, can we go and dry her bag?" And they sent me to the nurse's office. And the nurse's office got me to dry, and obviously, we got a note. So, we actually didn't end up going back to that lesson. We just walked around the whole time And honestly, it was so fun. And it's probably the days I always remember. When a supply teacher's not teaching you properly, so you're not really missing anything. So you basically just go around the whole school, have loads of fun, hide from the teachers and everything like that. It was fun. I'm not going to lie, it was fun. And obviously it was in my GCSE year, so I'm so glad I actually did some crazy things when I was at school. That was quite fun. Have you ever been in detention and why? I used to be like second late and I get a detention, so yes, I have had a detention. I have been in a detention. Yeah. What do you like the most about your school? So there's this teacher and she's so nice and she's always helped me, and when it's too loud something, I'm lost in her office. And that's probably the thing I liked most about school, but also that everyone in your class is your same age, you're relating to things, and you're just with people your own age. Because I remember when I had to stay in because of the virus for so long, not being around people my own age made me go mad, and it was so weird. I just being around people my own age was a good thing. Who's your favourite teacher and why? The teacher that used to stay in her office, and she used to let me go in her office. She was my favourite teacher. Give your best advice on surviving. I mean, I honestly don't think there is any proper advice I could give you. You just have to learn from it, live with it. It will definitely be things you'll remember, and I think also always be the hardest worker in the room. Try your best at everything, and also like you can do crazy things and that's fine. Don't feel bad if you do something wrong, and don't be bad if you don't do something, because in that moment if you didn't do that or you did do something, that was what was right for that moment, that's what you thought. But don't be horrible to anyone, that's what I'm going to say. Be horrible to anyone, be the hardest worker in the room. Only care about the people that care about you, and you can do some crazy things, that's what I would say. So that was I really hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure to give a big thumbs up. I really hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see you guys in the next one.